input.getAxis works in a similar fashion to getButton and getKey, but with some fundamental differences. GetKey and getButton both return a bool. The button is either pressed or not pressed, whilst getAxis returns a float value between -1 and +1. We set up axes in the input manager, which can be accessed via the edit, project settings, input top menu. With a button press, you'd only consider the positive button value. But with an axis, we should consider both positive and negative buttons, as well as gravity, sensitivity, dead, and snap. This is the standard behavior of getAxis horizontal. Remember that getAxis returns a float. As such, it is a sliding scale between -1 and 1. The gravity of the axis affects how fast this scale returns to zero after the button has been released. The higher the gravity, the faster the return. So if we increase the gravity from 3 to 100, we'll see this axis return to zero more quickly. Likewise, if we lower the value to 0.1, the axis value will return to zero more slowly. Sensitivity is the opposite of gravity and controls how quickly the return value of the input reaches 1 or -1. The higher the number, the more responsive, the lower the number, the more smooth. If we were using a joystick to represent our axis, then we wouldn't necessarily want to feel an effect from very small amounts of joystick movement. To avoid this, we have a dead zone. The higher the dead value is, the larger the dead zone, and the further the joystick must be moved in order for getAxis to return a non-zero value. The snap option allows you to return zero if both positive and negative buttons are held. To receive a value from horizontal or vertical axes, simply add an instance of input.getAxis horizontal or input.getAxis vertical to your code as seen here. You can also use input.getAxis raw to only return whole numbers and nothing in between. This is useful for 2D games that need precise controls rather than smoothed values. Note that this does not require the use of gravity or sensitivity.